Hello, welcome to Sneaky Russian's Guide to Dual Sport Riding in Limpopo Province.
So day one of our 2 day Limpopo trip, and we're off to an early start. The sun is only barely up and we're already turning wheels. First, we have to make our way to Ofkalako via some tar for a fuel top-up and also to set our tire pressures for gravel riding. Leaving Ofkalako, we head to the eastern entrance of the Lekhalamitse Reserve. The first gravel road we encounter is well graded and smooth, but the threat of livestock on the road is very real. At the main gate, we sign in and pay the prescribed fees to gain entry to the place of water. Just after Mafefe camp, we encounter the first of many stream crossings, hence the name, Place of Water. The water is mostly shallow, but the streams are rocky and slippery.
On the deeper reef.
As we near the southern gate of the reserve, we find a steep climb that is strewn with rocks. A good line and sustained momentum will see you easily make it all the way up. On this occasion, however, the hill got the better of us, and we had to fight our way up by pushing. Having passed through the southern gate, we made our way to the top of the mountain. The view from here is well worth the slightly technical climb.
My man!
Well done, buddy.
Descending into a valley, we continued south towards Penge. This jeep track is easy going and makes for a nice section to rest and recover, which is just as well because the next descent is rocky, loose and very steep. Our legs took a beating on this downhill, at least mine did. Richard opted for a more sedate approach.
This is for you, my boy. Shit.
Oh.
we were soon faced with a similar rocky track, only this time it was going up another mountain.
Hi.
Eh?
Hi. Was it a bright idea, was it to go riding in mountains again?
All right, we're up some godforsaken pass, middle of nowhere. It's rocky and it's f***ing tiring, but it's all ours and his and mine. We don't miss you, John.
Descending down towards the Olifants River, the other side of the mountain was less tricky, but still rocky and loose. Crossing the river turned out to be a bit trickier than expected, with the submerged rocks being slippery and uncooperative.
I'm getting wet because of you!
A quick stop in Penge for fuel and water saw us turning in a northwesterly direction on some gravel highways. This was just another opportunity to rest and recover while enjoying the scenery, especially since we had to cross the Olifants River again. Remaining on gravel highways, we continue towards the western side of the Lekhalamitse Reserve, passing through numerous nondescript villages.
Keep going, keep going! Or not.
Eventually, we started the Oribaragwanath Pass, so named after the original owner who made his fortune mining copper in what is now Zambia. Apparently, the word Baragwanath is of Gaelic origin and has something to do with eating bread.
Damn it.
The pass itself is also rocky and of a technical nature. Getting on towards the end of the day's ride, our tiredness and lapses of concentration didn't help either. Arriving at the western gate, we simply presented our papers from the main entrance and continued through to the downs. We followed a slightly technical jeep track up to the viewpoint called the Knuckles. Well worth it. It also makes a very nice way to end the day's ride.
Now this is worth all the shit.
Awesome, cool, superb, stunning.
That's what he says to camera. Tonight over beers, he's like, that was terrible, let's not do that again.